when it can have a very positive impact.
You never want a serious crisis to go to waste.
The way we're going to win over the long term is not just militarily. We've got to win over hearts and minds. And what that means is we've got to invest in countries that have no educational infrastructure, have no means for young people to get ahead. We've got to give them a stake in creating the kind of world order that I think all of us would like to see.
Stay tuned for Politics and Religion.
The EU group says belief in the Bible is hate speech. We've all known that this was going to happen, but we didn't expect it probably to happen quite this soon. However, many Christians in America have been wondering, at the rate our dominant culture is growing more hostile toward Christianity, how long it would be until public expression of Christian faith would be condemned as hate speech. Well, it's happened in Europe. What happened was some of the delegation from one of the member countries actually wanted to join one of the particular organizations, the Agency for Fundamental Rights. However, when the Agency for Fundamental Rights examined Romania's stance concerning homosexuality, that they see it as a human degenerate lifestyle, their application for membership was rejected because they say in this situation that that is nothing but hate speech. Now, this is where we're headed. Ladies and gentlemen, hear me clearly. When you believe the Bible, all the Bible, there are many people out there, all the way to the top of our government, that would accuse you of hate speech. Last year, in 2009, there was a terrible development that took place, and that was the passage of the hate crime. Now, they couldn't get it through. Here's what's happening in our country. Any law that cannot be passed, they hook it on to another must-pass piece of legislation. They did this with the Real ID Act in 2005. Now, you think about this. You think about a law that's going to require every person in America to have a national ID card, without which they cannot hold a job, cannot fly on an airplane, cannot function in society. And that law being slipped through the Senate on the back of a 1,000-page funding bill for our troops. Are you kidding me? Is that the way things are working in America? I thought they did this way in the Soviet Union. But in the United States of America, that's what happened. The administration of George W. Bush did it. Now, the administration of Barack Obama is no better because they knew they could not get the votes for this hate crime bill. I'm talking about a bill that's going to control what you say and ultimately what you even believe. I mean, here they are in this particular situation in Europe, and we're following very closely on the heels of Europe right now. And they're saying in Europe that because Romania ascribes to the biblical stance on homosexuality, they see that as hate speech. Now, if it's hate speech, and if there is a law against hate speech, then it becomes a crime. I mean, we're to the point now, and this article is pointing out, that we're to the point that belief in the Bible is a crime, that true Christianity is a crime. Now, some people say, well, how do you know that true Christianity teaches against homosexuality? I read the Bible. It's plain as the nose on your face. And it's time that someone come out openly and say, so the European group says that belief in the Bible is hate speech, and the Romanian delegation was eliminated from participation in some of the functions of the European Union because of that very thing. Now, in the meantime, Florida schools have banned, at least some schools, a certain Florida district school has banned the Bible on Religious Freedom Day. Now, this is an astounding development as well, because here you have this school. Let me just read a little bit of it to you. Maryland-based Liberty Council filed a lawsuit Thursday to overturn a ban on Bible distribution on public school campuses in Collier County. According to the Liberty Council, the Collier County School Board allowed World Changers to distribute free Bibles to students during off-school hours on Religious Freedom Day. But now the school officials claim that Bibles do not provide any educational benefits to the students and that the distribution should stop. It's astounding that these kinds of things can be developing right here in the United States of America.
The Bible actually tells us that there's a war coming that's going to kill 2 billion human beings.
Define marriage.
I believe that marriage is the union between a man and a woman. But I do believe in civil unions.
Hamas has said clearly and publicly that they are not going to continue the truce, and the same day they attacked Israel.
When the confirmation of the covenant occurs, it marks the beginning of the final 7 years to Armageddon.
Today is Friday Open Lines. Give us a call right now, 1-877-END-TIME.
Look, there are two things I don't discuss: politics and religion.
In my house, we don't talk about politics and we don't talk about religion.
I'll talk to you about anything except politics and religion.
I never talk about politics and religion.
Politics determines how we'll live here on Earth. Religion determines how we'll live forever. I'm Irvin Baxter. I think it's time we talk about it.
Well, it's that favorite day of the week when all of us enjoy Open Line. That's when we talk about whatever we want to talk about. It's been an interesting week here at Politics and Religion. Let's quickly recap some of the things we've been talking about this week. A lot being said this week about immigration. Of course, it is a hot topic, and I felt like we should talk about it because immigration is the issue that's being exploited as an excuse to implement a national ID card here in the United States of America. They're actually